Previously on Whispering Willows.
Hey, Buford. What you want me to find?
And now we continue.
First Flying Hawk leaves me, and now Skyflower and Mr. Halloran. Just when I was beginning to like him, too. He turned out to be a nice man and a good person in the end, despite some of the things he'd done in life. I'm happy for him, and for Skyflower. They've been kept from the afterlife for way too long. It was high time for both of them to go home. Yeah, it was. Right then, shall we take the elevator? Chapter 3, Worthman's Woman. Love seat. I'd love to take a seat, but I have to find Dad. 2 seconds, Eleni. You can sit down for 2 seconds. New note added. Oh, it's another one from Fleur. Worth and Willows won the first election for mayor last week. This place is going to be a proper town under his direction, it said. I've heard that he comes from New England, where the clouds are black from industry. They say he knows what a proper town is. Oh, I cannot wait to see what becomes of my home. The future is rich with possibilities. I've met men who came hundreds of miles to see me dance. It is flattering beyond all notion, but that is not the best of my news. This new mayor came to watch me dance this evening. I felt his eyes as he watched me, and it quickened my heart. He even sent me flowers after the show. The world is a dream, and I hope not to wake up. You don't want to know what he's really like, love. Bathroom. How nice. Tiny little door. Press space to pick up the note. Darby. I do not know how much longer I can take this hot torment. The efforts of my dear Claire no longer help to soothe me when I'm in the grips of terror. I found myself awakened while sleepwalking, and I seem to head to the same place every night. I head to where it all happened, where my torment began. Such is my fate. I shall burn in hell's fire, I know it to be true. I have sought the help of holy men, and even their blessings cannot cure me of my affliction. I think at times it would be better for me to find the blackness I long for. Death whispers to me in my sleep, and I want to follow it. Don't, man. Or maybe he did. Maybe it's too late. Maybe a lot of things. Who's this? Oh, hello. Oh, you're beautiful. It's Fleur. Oh, no, I've lost it. It's as though a part of me is missing. Please, little girl, help me find it. Help me find my lost love letter. Wardham's words always worked so well to soothe me.
Probably wouldn't if you knew what he did for a living. But
I met this lady who won't stop crying. Her name is Fleur, and I think she might be French, but I'm not sure. Her accent is hard for me to figure out. You're not very good at accents, Eleanor. You're good at everything else, so that's cool. She keeps telling me she's lost a love letter. She's very upset over it. I think she's being a little overdramatic, to be honest, but I guess I'll help her. I really don't see why girls go so crazy over love letters. Seems a little silly to me. Well, I guess if it was from somebody you liked and actually wanted. Wait, is that... Something clicked. Huh. Ah, there, a button. Ah, clever, Sarah, very clever. Let's go down. This is a really big house, bigger than I expected. I bet all those people on there are Kickstarter backers. I have another game that I want to play for you all eventually. I'm a little bit reluctant to play it at the moment, just because it has a very sad ending. Not the game itself, but the company that made it. Whoa, Jesus Christ, every new ghost I see seems to be losing more and more body parts. Chef Smeraldo? Found a knife with blood all over it the other day. Don't know where it came from. I hope you didn't put it in your eye. Figured it was left in the kitchen, so I left it there. Guess it's probably here then. Somewhere. Okay, hang on. Let's go back. Oh, stovetop. What does that say?
This is not what a kitchen is supposed to smell like. No, a kitchen is supposed to smell of chips and baking. Okay, unlock that door. I don't remember having a key, but I unlocked the door. So, I'm not complaining. Wait, where am I? Haven't I been here before? Oh, so I have. I'm back at the front now. Let's see. The door's locked. Damn it. Space to open the cupboard. Is that a knife? That is, that's a bloody knife. Which I can possess. What the frick? Are you kidding me? Why am I possessing a knife? Oh wait, because it's too high for me to pick up. I hope you don't expect me to use this. Oh. Your knife has been used or something, or someone. Don't like it. Don't like it. Space to go through the door. Oh, we can go down here. Right, let's just go down. Ooh, a wine cellar. And a note. I do what I can to keep my worth relationship with Wortham interesting, but I worry that he no longer holds any interest in me. He's much colder and distant, where he used to be warm and loving. And while he still visits me almost nightly, I feel a change is overcoming. I do not know what it could be that has caused such a change in the man I love so much. Murder. I can see it lurking behind his eyes in intense anger, and I do not know where it comes from, nor how it went so unnoticed for so long. When he looks at me with those eyes, I become scared and unable to speak much, or even more. I fear what hides behind the irises. I hope he does not turn on me some way. I hope so too, Fleur. I think we've got a knife will do, but maybe she'll be interested. No, she hasn't. Poor lady. She loved him, she came here for a better life, she got murdered. Story told time and time again, unfortunately. Won't hurt, since I can apparently get through any small space. Also, Elena is pretty terrified of those things, so, you know, spare the poor child. Oh, hang on, have I been up here before? Surely must have. Maybe I haven't. Yeah, I must have come up here before. Or not. You're new. You also look kind of like me.
Emiko Minami.
Ohio. I am one of Wortham's many guests. A pleasure to meet you.
You too, man. Sorry about your being dead and all. So how come one of his guests died here? What happened?
Another note. My hands tremble, and it is all I can do to hold the pen as I write herein. I have even missed the inkwell on a few occasions. I have only just come home from the most wonderful evening of my life. I feel I need to catch my breath. Wortham Willows, the town's mayor, the richest, most influential man for hundreds of miles around, took me out for a night on the town. And what a night it was, notwithstanding the secrecy. I've never been treated so much like royalty. I could not believe it. Every second I was there was amazing. We had a feast with dishes that covered every inch of the table. Afterwards, he treated me to a play. I've never been to a play before. My head still swims from all the fine wine and excitement. He's truly a romantic gentleman, this Wortham Willows. No, he's not. I hope to see him again soon, but for now, I must rest. I can feel my heart flutter in my chest. Poor Fleur. I am so sorry that things got fucked up for you, sweetheart. Like, you didn't deserve that. You deserved better. You really did. You all deserved better than this, surely. Okay, I've already been in there. Okay, so. Took me about 20 minutes to figure this out, but you remember the conservatory? That we couldn't get into because it was covered in stuff? Yep. We have a knife now. A knife covered in blood and other gross things, but it's a knife and it will serve its purpose.
Nope, that's that. That's not the conservatory. Might have gone the wrong way. There's a conservatory out the front. I forget. There's a conservatory in the garden. I forget that too. Oh no, there it is. Right, lovely. There we go. We use the knife, and now we can go in the creepy conservatory. Gotta say, didn't get much life out of it. I bet people like my dad have been hired to water this. Is it implying that your dad's not very good at gardening? Can you hear that? Huh? Guess that was the point. A key? I wonder who hid this in the vase. I don't know, but... Oh, gosh. I'm gonna guess you're gonna be covered in vines? Oh my flipping gosh. I was left with quite a chip on my shoulder when my parents died. Requiring me to hope for my scholarly pursuits and run the family flower shop, yeah, I can see you have a massive chip in your shoulder. It was only when my son grew weary of England and wished to seek his fortune that I left that dreadful career. And yet, here I am, back at it again. Feels like an eternity. This is a weird game. This is a very weird game. I can always smell the leftover perfume. Well, that's most definitely a love letter. My dearest Fleur, the past weeks we've spent together have been a blurry dream. When I'm with you, time flies so that the days seem to blend happily into one another. You make my heart feel so full there is naught to do but weep and thank God for your presence on this earth. But I fear people will talk behind our backs and my reputation will be besmirched. I must protect my good name. It is my livelihood. I'd like to propose you live with me, my love. It must be in secret, but it is the only way I can see for us to be together. And we must be together. We will communicate via secret messages. But that's something to discuss when we next meet. Until then, you are forever in my heart. Love, Wartham. I've taken an interest in a young dancer named Fleur from the saloon I own in Tyne. She is likewise interested in me, and I have begun my courtship of her. In secret, of course. As the town's mayor, I can't be seen with such a woman, so I must keep her from prying eyes. I will hide her away here in the observatory, so that only the servants know of her presence. She reminds me of Martha at times, the way she makes me feel. But I affirm it can be nothing beyond mere whimsy. I cannot afford such scandal. I will do what I have to in order to ensure my secret does not get out. The more I see of Wortham, the less I like the guy. I mean, Jesus. Nothing possessable. Recording's still going. Seems to be. Okay. No. Why am I hearing a... tap, tap, tapping? Oh yeah, this is that guy, isn't it? Hey man. Yeah. There doesn't seem to be much in the conservatory. Well, I guess I better go back to her. I'm sure once I give her the love letter, she'll be able to give me some kind of secret message or something like that. Not that I really want to know what Workman is up to in his downtime. Being honest, he sounds like a complete creep. Hey, Fleur! Oh, thank you so much, Elena. You have no idea what this means to me. Please, take this ring as a token of my appreciation. Workman and I used it to hide secret message that could only be seen with it. But I don't need it anymore. You have helped me more than I know, Elena. Goodbye. I hope you manage to find your father. Workman's ring. Aw, she's gone already. I was just getting to know her. Goodbye, Fleur. You were so lovely. Press to read the symbol.
Go to wine cellar. Okay, I guess.